This is Minister Robert Mixon coming before you once again in behalf of the Cheraw Church of the Living God, located at 947 Beaver Dam Road in Hartsville, South Carolina. At Audible services, Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m., Friday night at 8 p.m., Saturday morning service at 10:30, and afternoon service at 3 p.m. every Saturday. You're always welcome to be with us in our worship service. Now the Bible tells us in John 8:31-32.
Then said Jesus to those Jews which believed on him.
If
ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed.
If you continue in my word, then are you my disciples indeed.
And you shall know the truth.
You shall know the truth.
And the truth shall make you free.
John 17:17 tell us exactly what is truth.
Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth.
For thy word is truth. All of the word of God is truth.
Amen.
But you got men and women walking in lies.
Amen.
And the Bible said we shall know the truth.
Amen.
All right. Romans 3:3.
For what if some did not believe? Shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect?
The Bible says, shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect?
God forbid.
God forbid.
Yea, let man be true.
The Bible says that God be true.
But every man a liar.
Amen. 2 Timothy 3:16 say what?
All scripture is given by the inspiration of God.
All right. All scripture is given by the inspiration of God.
And is profitable for doctrine.
This is the only thing profitable for doctrine.
For reproof. For correction. For instruction in righteousness.
The scripture will correct us and instruct us if we will take the correction.
Amen.
Matthew 4:4.
But he answered and said.
It is written.
Man should not live by bread alone. But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God.
All right. But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Now, some will take part of the scripture, and another part they fail to believe it.
Amen.
But remember the Bible said, let God be true, and every man a liar. Romans 15:4.
For whatsoever thing were written aforetime were written for our learning. That we through patience. And comfort of the scriptures. Might have hope.
The things that were written aforetime. Now, most people in mainstream religion say that these things of the Old Testament were done away with. No longer exists, but Matthew 5:17. Let us hear what it said. The things that were written aforetime were written for our learning. Alright, what it said?
Think not that I am come to destroy the law.
All right, now some are saying that the law is done away with, but Jesus himself says,
think not that I am come to destroy the law.
See, Jesus knew that a time was coming when they were going to try to do away with the law.
Amen.
But he said, think not that I've come to destroy the law.
Or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
All right. I didn't come to destroy, but to fulfill.
Amen.
Isaiah 42. And let us begin at the 21st verse. Now, mainstream religion claim to be following Jesus, but yet are saying that the law is done away with, and Jesus plainly said he did not come to destroy the law.
Amen.
What is it said in Isaiah?
The Lord is well pleased for his righteousness. Say, he will magnify the law.
The Bible said he will magnify the law.
And make it honorable.
And make it honorable, not destroy it. Magnify the law.
Amen.
Psalm 19 and 7. Oh, there's no problem with the law. Jesus upheld the law.
Amen.
And see, and this is why mainstream religion cannot understand what's written in the scripture, because what God gives us to open up our understanding, they're saying that is done away with. Psalm 19 and 7, what is it?
The law of the Lord is perfect.
All right, the Bible said the law of the Lord is perfect.
Converting the soul.
Converting the soul.
The testimony of the Lord is sure. Making wise the simple.
Making wise the simple.
Amen.
Now, these things were written for our learning.
Amen.
That we through patience and comfort of the scripture might have hope. Romans 7 and 12.
Amen.
Let us hear what it says.
Amen.
Wherefore the law is holy, and the commandment holy.
The law is holy,
and the commandment holy.
And the commandment holy.
And just.
And just.
And good.
And good.
Amen.
Now there's nothing wrong with the law.
Amen.
But we were speaking to you concerning talking about the mark of the beast, and we were coming from the book of Daniel, and we were in the seventh chapter of Daniel, where Daniel saw the four beasts, and Daniel also let us know what was the interpretation of these beasts.
Amen.
And he let us know that they were kingdoms ruled over by kings.
Amen.
And we get that information from the seventh chapter of the book of Daniel. And in that second chapter of Daniel, when Nebuchadnezzar had the dream with this great statue, this image that was so frightening.
Amen.
And Daniel, God gave him understanding of vision and dream, and he was able to interpret, and he let King Nebuchadnezzar know that he represented the head of gold.
Amen. Amen.
And if you go to history, you will find that the Babylonian Empire was the first world ruling kingdom.
Amen.
And we also showed you from the fifth chapter of the book of Daniel how that the Medes and the Persians overthrew the Babylonian kingdom.
Amen.
And you can also find this in history. And now we want to look at, now the Medes and Persians took over from the Babylonians, and it was already written, it was already prophesied that it was going to happen.
Amen.
And also, the kingdom changed hand again.
Amen.
Let us go back to the book of Daniel, the 8th chapter. And let us begin at the 3rd verse. Now remember, Daniel said, these four beasts are four kings that shall arise out of the earth.
Then I lifted up my eyes and saw, and behold, there stood before the river a ram.
A ram.
Which had two horns.
Now remember, Daniel already let us know that these beasts represent kingdoms.
Amen.
And kings.
Amen.
So this follows the same principle here. Talking about this ram, what does it say?
And the two horns were high.
The Bible said the two horns were high.
But one was higher than the other.
Mm-hmm.
and the higher came up last.
All right, now remember, the Babylonian kingdom came first.
Amen.
Then the Medes and the Persians, and this ram is representing the Medes and the Persians. That's why there are two horns.
Amen.
Because two rulers ruled this kingdom together.
Amen.
And one was higher or greater than the other.
Amen.
All right, what else is it?
I saw the ram pushing westward.
All right. I saw the ram pushing westward.
And northward.
Uh-huh.
And southward.
Right.
So that no beast might stand before him.
All right, now remember what we got going on here. We got one kingdom against another kingdom.
Amen.
One kingdom attacking another kingdom.
Amen.
Not animals.
Amen.
Now we are talking about the Medes and the Persians, which took over the Babylonian kingdom.
Amen.
Now they are being attacked.
Amen.
What else is it?
Neither was there any that could deliver out of his hand.
All right, talking about the Medes and the Persians now.
But he did according to his will,
mm-hmm,
and became great.
And became great.
And as I was considering, behold, an he-goat came from the west on the face of the whole earth.
All right, so now you're talking about a he-goat coming up against the ram.
Amen.
And this he-goat is a kingdom.
Amen.
Ruled over by a king. Yes. What else is it?
And touched not the ground. And the goat had a notable horn between his eyes.
All right, this goat had a notable horn, talking about the ruler, the leader of this kingdom.
Amen.
All right.
And he came to the ram that had two horns. Which had two horns.
All right.
Which I had seen standing before the river.
All right. Now remember, in plain language, he's talking about the Medes and the Persians with the two horns.
Man.
And ran into him in the fury of his power.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw him come close unto the ram. And
all right.
And he would move with a collar against him.
All right. He was angry against this ram.
Amen.
And smote the ram.
Mm-hmm.
And break his two horns. And there was no power in the ram to stand before him.
All right, so when you go to history, you will find that Babylon was the first world ruling kingdom. Mm-hmm. Then the Medes and the Persians.
Mm-hmm.
And history will tell you that the Grecians under Alexander the Great,
amen,
was that third kingdom.
Amen.
And this is Alexander the Great power attacking the Medes and the Persians.
Amen.
Now history will also tell you that the Grecians, when they came into power, they were very quick and swift in destroying their enemy.
Amen.
What does it say?
But he cast him down to the ground.
All right, cast him down to the ground.
And stamped upon him.
Mm-hmm.
And there was none that could deliver the ram out of his hand.
All right, so this he-goat represents the Grecian kingdom under Alexander the Great, and the legend has it that Alexander conquered everything in sight and sat down and cried because he had nothing else to conquer.
Amen. Amen.
What else is it?
Therefore, the he-goat waxed very great.
Said the he-goat waxed very great. So what we're talking about, the Grecian kingdom under Alexander the Great waxed very great.
And when he was strong, the great horn was broken.
All right, and so what we're talking about here, this leader of the Grecian kingdom, which was Alexander the Great, he died in his early age of around 33 years old.
Amen.
At the height of his power.
Amen.
What else is it?
And for it came up for notable ones toward the four winds of heaven.
All right. So now remember the beast that Daniel saw in the seventh chapter, that third beast had four heads.
Amen.
Now remember, when you go to history, you will find after the death of Alexander the Great, there were four generals that came up in the kingdom.
Amen.
And ruled the territory after Alexander.
Amen.
So this is what the Bible is talking about. What else it say?
and out of one of them came forth a little horn, which wipes the seed and grape.
All right, so we see the succession of kingdom. We see the kingdom change hands. The Babylonians left the rule to the Medes and the Persians. The Medes and the Persians were overtaken by the Grecian under Alexander the Great.
Amen.
Now remember that fourth kingdom Daniel was concerned about.
Amen.
And he wanted to know the truth about that fourth kingdom.
Amen.
Let us go again to the book of Revelation, the 13th chapter. Now remember, we're trying to get to the mark of the beast. Now we're looking at the beast and what the beast represents.
Amen.
And then we're going to get to the mark of the beast.
Amen.
Revelation 13, beginning at the first verse.
And I stood upon the sand of the sea and saw the beast rise up out of the sea.
All right, remember, Daniel already enlightened us that this beast is the kingdom.
Yes, sir.
Having seven heads and 10 horns.
All right, so this particular beast, one beast having seven heads and 10 horns.
And upon his horns, 10 crowns.
Mm-hmm.
And upon his heads, the name of blasphemy.
Right.
Blasphemy. And the beast which I saw was like unto a leopard. And
all right, the Bible said the beast was like unto what?
A leopard.
Like unto a leopard.
And his feet were as the feet of a bear.
Mm-hmm.
And his mouth as the mouth of a lion.
Mouth as the mouth of a lion.
And the dragon gave him his power and his seat and great authority.
All right, now remember the Bible interprets its own signs and symbols and figurative language. And when we're talking about the dragon,
yes, sir,
we're talking about none other than Satan himself.
Amen.
Now, if you notice, this beast had the characteristics of the beast that Daniel saw.
Amen.
In the seventh chapter of the book of Daniel.
Amen.
But
Amen.
They were all together here.
Amen.
When John saw it.
Uh-huh.
And they were all combined into one beast, and there's a reason for that.
Amen.
What does it say?
And I saw one of his heads as it were wounded to death.
All right, one of the heads of this beast was wounded to death.
And his deadly wound was healed.
All right, now the Bible said his deadly wound was healed. Now, what most people don't understand about this wound and the healing, that the way it's written is like the wound came and then it was healed all of a sudden.
Mm-hmm.
But history will tell you, if you know what to look for, there was 78 years in between the wounding of the head and the healing of the wound.
Amen.
But my time is out. We want you to tune in, and we're going to continue to show you in plain language, not from my imagination or from the imagination of a man, but from what's written in the scripture, and we're going to show you all about this beast, even about the mark. This is Minister Mixon saying bye now.